It's no secret that you can make a lot of money working in tech. It's so important though that you ensure to educate yourself on what salary to expect, what really is included in total compensation, and so much more. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you some of the best resources to look for and do research on when you are looking for a tech job or maybe you are transitioning into a new role. But before we get into it, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related content. Shout out to some of these subscribers here. Thank you for your comments, questions, feedback, love. You know, I love you. Okay, let's get right into it. Whether you are someone who is first entering into the tech industry, or maybe you are someone who's mid or senior level looking to get a different job, being up to date and ensuring you are educated on what salary or total compensation is expected throughout the industry is absolutely key to ensuring setting yourself up for success. Before we get into some of the best resources to research tech salaries, let's really break down what a tech salary, or should I say total compensation, really entails. To put it simply, total compensation includes all the different ways that you get paid. So it's more than just your salary. Some examples of total compensation can include base salary, benefits, bonus, stock options, but let's break them down even further. Okay, let's start with base salary, something that we are all familiar with. Base salary is something that you are guaranteed to get regardless of your performance or working extra hard, anything like that. This is your base salary, something that you are guaranteed to have. Okay, that's pretty obvious. Let's jump into bonus. A bonus is essentially a percentage, or often done as a percentage of your base salary. So for example, let's say 10 to 15%. And unlike base salary, this is not fixed every year, so it may vary year to year. Usually a bonus is given out once a year. So for example, a lot of companies give out bonuses at end of year based on your performance and hitting target goals. Okay, another big piece of total compensation is equity. And this is where it gets a little bit more complex. The essential goal of having equity compensation is that employees see, as long as the company is doing good and furthering doing good, their equity compensation continues to rise. So it's kind of incentive for employees to really want to see the company succeed. Equity compensation is essentially a strategy that is used to improve a business's cash flow, and a lot of times startups offer equity instead of a salary, and it really depends on how much you believe in the startup, but I would also say higher level companies really offer equity on top of a salary as well, included in the total compensation package. And the last one I want to talk about is benefits. Benefits include health benefits, dental benefits, different benefits that you can use throughout the year. The goal of benefits is that when you have benefits, they will offset a lot of expenses that you would have otherwise if you were to pay out of pocket. The key with benefits though is you actually have to use them. More often than not, we think we have these great benefit packages and they kind of lure us in with that, only for us to go throughout the year with really not using them all, such as massages or extra spending health benefits. But when you need them, they really come in handy. Okay, now that we have a pretty good understanding as to what a tech salary or tech compensation really includes, let's dive into some of the top salary or total compensation tech reporters. These are two resources that I use all the time. I'm always looking because they do two things. One, they go based on location. Where are you located? Two, it's based on other people actually inputting their salaries, which I think is huge to actually hear from, you know, your peers working in the industry, what they are making. The first site I want to talk about is Levels.fyi. I am sure you have heard about it before, and if you haven't, I highly suggest you go check it out. I recently discovered Levels.fyi maybe a year and a half ago. Up until then, I didn't even know it existed. I don't know how I was living in a rock or under a rock. And what they do is they really highlight in different areas of tech, different jobs in tech, different salaries and total compensation. So they do both. They will break it down from your base salary, and then they also will include, if you were to include, bonus and equity on top of that. Okay, I'm going to pull it up right here. This is a homepage for me when I go to levels.fyi, and you can see here they go right into some of the top companies: Google, Facebook, Microsoft. You can toggle here to see different roles. For this video, let's stick with software engineer, as I know a lot of you are software engineers. So let's go by location. Well, let's go to San Fran. Obviously, this is going to be significantly higher than other areas in the world because it's a tech hub, but it's really good to understand what they are paying there. I also think it's key on Levels.fyi how they do by level, so you can really research based on what level you are going into to have an understanding of what to expect. So if we go to, say, L1, Netflix, view full offer, and you can see here what they are reporting is 170, and then with a bonus of 3,000. And it really goes on and on. I mean, there's 1,500 different reports, so some are more accurate than others, of course, but it kind of gives you, I really like up here where it gives you a median of what to expect. And you can also see the top paying companies, which is really huge. And then if we go, just for fun, let's go to the top paying report of 2020. I wonder if this is what you expected. I didn't expect Lyft to be number one, to be honest, but as you can see, the headquarters are obviously, most of them are out of San Fran. And the compensation, the total compensation, please do not skew this with the base salary. This is total compensation that we spoke about. So let's go to Lyft, 230. Base salary is 136. We have stocks and we have bonuses. Also, I love how they have different kind of services they offer, from one-on-one salary negotiation support and in-depth resume review. I'm just a huge fan of this company. This is not sponsored by any means. I just am kind of obsessed with these resources they provide and being on top and having the education needed to negotiate your salary or your total compensation. And with resources like this, it really empowers the employee to have an understanding of what others are getting paid and what they should be expecting too. Okay, let's move on to the second one that I love, which is Blind. This is great, especially if you want to compare salaries from company to company. So once again, with Blind, you can select a company. I find with Blind, they really focus on higher level companies, or when I say higher level, I mean more kind of FAANG-like companies. They also do Microsoft, Salesforce, Uber, that kind of thing. But once again, they have a ton of different roles. Let's go to software engineering again. You can also search, for example, like your based on what you're currently getting and submit it. So with Blind, I like it because a lot of people submit their current total compensation. So you're hearing from people who are actually working in the industry. And also too, if you're looking for a job under Who's Hiring, they have tons of different jobs where to apply, and these are for some of the biggest companies in the world, and they're jobs that are located throughout the entire world. It's not just like a San Fran kind of thing. If you're in India, if you are in, where else do we have? We have tons of remote jobs. We have a lot of for North America. I mean, it's just a very valuable resource. And I've been using Blind for a while now. Once again, I think I found out about it around the same time as Levels.fyi. And these are two resources that have honestly changed my, if I was to go and get another job, I mean, I love where I'm at and all that, but if I was to go through the job hunting and interviewing process, these are the two resources I would use hands down. They are accurate, they are up to date, they are from people who are working in the industry. So it's kind of a win-win on all fronts. I really hope this will help you if you are someone looking to enter into the tech industry and not really sure what salary or total compensation to expect, but also too, if you already are in the tech industry and you were like me, just didn't know about these resources, I hope it will really help you or give you an understanding for when you're getting promoted or looking for a new job as what salary to negotiate and to expect. If you haven't already, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. Leave in the comments other videos you want me to make, and I will see you soon. Thanks, everyone.